Prairie boy.
Okay, I've been using this bag for about 2 years now, and it's definitely in need of some TLC. This is my own personal number 72 in natural tooling, and I purposely didn't treat it with anything. I wanted to see exactly what it would do after a year or two of use, having not applied any kind of treatment, oil, conditioner, anything to it. So this is straight out of the box with about 2 years of use. And it's definitely taken a beating. There's a bunch of diagonal water marks where it was rained on. Oh man, all kinds of weird stains. There's a few spots that look really dry, definitely need some attention. Some indigo stain from my jeans. But overall, it's held up really well. So this is some 3 to 4 ounce natural tooling that hasn't seen the sun or any kind of wear on it, brand new. And comparing it to this, it's actually pretty similar in color. It doesn't seem like this bag got a whole lot of sunlight. Although it does have a pretty decent farmer's tan. This bag's definitely overdue for some conditioning, so I figured I'd bring it along with me. Because this is natural tooling, it has zero oils or waxes in the leather at all, so it's really dry. So what I'd like to do is give it a healthy dose of Neatsfoot oil and let the leather really drink it up. And then I'll finish it off with some tan coat, which will just give it a little bit of a finished glossy look to it. So I just warmed up a little pot of Neatsfoot oil. It always helps to have the oil just a little bit warm. It just helps it permeate the leather a little bit better. Not boiling, of course, just warm. And I'm gonna use a wool dauber like this to apply it on. I'm just gonna go pretty light because this leather is only 4 to 5 ounces at its thinnest point. Some of these parts are doubled up like the straps, but for the most part this leather's pretty lightweight, and so if I were to just immerse it in oil like I have with other projects, it would drink up way too much of it and then just bleed oil for the rest of its life. So I think we're gonna be much better off just applying a light coat and then maybe doing another one if it seems like it needs it. Jacket, laptop, some adapters, a pen, and we're free. And then I'm gonna remove the shoulder strap. It's probably gonna be a lot better if we remove the front straps off of this thing and pull them out of those lash tabs. Woo, these tan lines are getting me. Before we start oiling this thing, I'm gonna take a brush and just brush off like any loose dust or just to get rid of any crusty stuff that's on the bag. And by the way, if you're gonna do this, it's better to use a natural hair brush, nothing synthetic. This is probably gonna take me a minute. It's always a little scary at first oiling up your leather because it looks so drastic, the color difference and the way it affects the leather, but natural tooling leather like this drinks up oil so fast that it probably, after one coat, probably won't even look like you did anything. Should throw an apron on. This is how you ruin clothes, you know? that definitely looks pretty spotty right now and uneven, but it will dry up and even out. So I'm gonna go set it outside for a little bit. I think it's a little bit too late in the day to get any direct sunlight, but the cool breeze might help it dry up. But either way, I'm gonna wanna let it dry overnight completely before I put on the tan coat or anything else. So I think we're done for today. All right, so it's been about 24 hours and this thing's soaked up about as much as it's going to. And I was actually pretty surprised. It went on a little heavier than I thought. There's so many factors that come into play when you're doing stuff like this. I've got this little piece of scrap here that I was testing a whole bunch of different oils and conditioners. And I tried out Chamberlain's tan coat, Neatsfoot oil, Chamberlain's water protectant, Nick wax, which you can hardly see, saddle soap, bag coat, Smith leather balm. I just really wanted to get a feel for how the leather reacts to everything. And what I realized is that the wallets that I've treated in the past with Neatsfoot oil, for the most part, I've just used a rag to apply it. And I guess what I'm finding is that the rag applies a much lighter coat of Neatsfoot oil because the rag absorbs most of the oil, as opposed to the wool dauber, which just kind of lathers it on there really thick. With some of the test pieces, I've gone on and applied one coat of Neatsfoot oil with a rag, and then it dries up and you can hardly even tell you've done anything, so you have to do a few coats. And I think I was going into this bag with that mindset. It went on a little bit heavier than I thought, so it's a lot darker than I was planning originally, although it doesn't look bad. It's pretty inconsistent. I must have gone a lot heavier on, you know, this strap versus this strap, and like this lash tab's really dark where it's a lot lighter over here. If the whole bag would have turned out something more like this, I think I would have been really happy. But if I was gonna give some advice to someone looking to do the same thing with their bag, I would recommend, if you're gonna use Neatsfoot oil, to apply it with a rag. Just go a lot lighter and take it in steps. Or one of my favorites is this Chamberlain's conditioner right here. It didn't darken it all that much, but it gave it kind of like a glossy, really finished feel, similar to the tan coat, where I'm gonna apply the tan coat anyway, but that's a second step in the process. So I'm wondering if you just knock it out both with that conditioner, it gives it a really nice finish. And then also Smith's Leather Balm is a really good finish as well. It doesn't darken it hardly at all. You can barely see any discoloration there. So Smith's Leather Balm is a really natural formula, so it's always a really safe route to go. Neatsfoot oil, especially when applied like this, is really good for heavy duty leather. Like it can really wake an old saddle up. But in the end, it's really fun to experiment and try new things. And even though this is quite a bit darker than I was planning, it's kind of fun to have something totally unique, and there's a lot of character in it. I think it's going to age beautifully from here. So to finish it up, I'm gonna apply a light coat of tan coat to the whole thing. That'll be kind of a nice finished sealant for the bag. The Neatsfoot oil has kind of a matted texture to it, so it'll give it like a nice glossy kind of finished feel to it. I'm gonna stuff this thing. I think it'll be a little bit easier to wipe down. Throw my jacket in there. Some of these rags. The bag's looking so much healthier than it did. I'm really loving the color that we're getting down here and all around here. Like I said, I think it got a little bit too heavy on these lash tabs and maybe like a red around here and on this strap, but for the most part, this golden brown color just, but it just doesn't feel dry and cracky anymore. It used to kind of have this like wrinkly kind of cracked feel to it when you'd use it, and now it just feels really soft and pliable. This color right here, this is what I was hoping for the whole bag. Much more uniform, clean, kind of golden, russety color. That's what I had envisioned. And I think for the most part, it turned out that way, except for this lash tab. It's so frustrating because that just, this whole section right here just got a little bit too much oil. And so we got kind of a multicolored, contrasty thing going on here. But you know what? Makes it unique, makes it have some character. It's a beautiful bag either way. I'm really excited to keep carrying this thing. So just based on what I've learned from this specific experience, as well as other ones, I just wanted to give you a few recommendations. If you've got a natural vegetable tan product, meaning it's completely undyed, untreated, no oils, waxes, anything, and you just want to straight waterproof it, and you just want to keep that clean, light tan look without changing the color, I would recommend using this Nickwax waterproofer. This has been the only thing I've seen that you can spray on natural vegetable tan leather and not have any effect to the color. It's wild. And it makes it so that water will just bead up and roll right off. No issues. That stuff's really good for waterproofing. And I think I'm gonna spray this thing down before we totally finish this thing up. So if you've got some dehydrated, you know, cracked, dried up vegetable tan leather, and you just wanna revive it, bring some life back into it, I would recommend some Phoebing's Neatsfoot oil. But like I said, just go easy on it, go really light, and then graduate up if you think it needs some more. But the leather really drinks this stuff up, just absorbs it and gives it some life. So this stuff's always a good option. If you wanna try out something a little bit more mild, this Chamberlain's Leather Milk is actually really good stuff. I've had it sitting here in the shop for a long time and haven't used it. But this stuff gave it a really nice finish, honestly, and it didn't change the color up too much. So this is the Chamberlain's conditioner. It darkened it just a little, just gave it a little bit of a sun-kissed look, and it kind of keeps the more reddish tones of the leather, and also kind of a glossy feel, which I like. And then this is Smith's, which has always been proven in my book, really good stuff. Gives it a little bit more of a matted texture, kind of a waxy feel. You know, if there was only one thing you were gonna buy, I would probably suggest Smith's, because you're gonna get, with that little bit of a waxy, balmy texture, it's gonna give it a little bit of waterproofing, make it a little bit more resistant in the weather. You know, you can even heat it up just a little bit, you know, give it a few applications and really let the leather drink it up, and that stuff will just do wonders for vegetable tan leather. The reason I love Smith's is because it's really natural ingredients. There's only like 3 or 4 ingredients in it. It's made in the US, and even better, made by our friends Shane and Mandy. They're a really cool little family operation, just doing amazing things. So if you were just gonna buy one of these and you just want general purpose all around leather care, I would pick up Smith's. You can buy it on our website, but you can also get it on their website and a few other places. Anyway, there are so many things out there to consider when you're talking about leather care. If you have any specific questions about taking care of your leather, let me know. You know, leave it in the comments or something, and I'm happy to help out. There's a lot to consider, and I'm not an expert in the topic, but I'm happy to, you know, share what I do know. So leave a comment. All right, thanks for watching, guys. Bye.
Buddy's old man is back on the booze. He's swinging a driver at a big bull moose. Keeps getting on the goddamn property, or so he says. Cigarettes are expensive and whiskey ain't cheap. Winters are bitter, but the summers are sweet. You can get some modestly priced smokes over at the Rez, if you're so inclined. Most of my time spent in the big blue van, just traveling the country with a 5-piece band.